Breaking news tonight. Police desperately searching for that beautiful three-year-old Florida girl named Kaylee after her grandparents report her missing. Little Kaylee now not seen for 9 long weeks. Last seen with her mother. Fast breaking developments tonight. Just moments ago, a California bounty hunter and bail bondsman arrive at the Orange County Jail to put up that $50,000 to bond out Casey Anthony. Mom Casey will now walk out of jail early tomorrow morning. That bounty hunter believes three-year-old Kaylee is still alive, and he says once Mom Casey is out of confinement, she'll loosen up and talk. An arraignment set for tomorrow morning, but when will key evidence, hair and fluid from Casey Anthony's car trunk finally be revealed? Tonight, what happened to three-year-old Kaylee Anthony?
Breaking news in the case of missing three-year-old Florida toddler Kaylee Anthony. Just moments ago, a bail bondsman posted the money to get tot mom Casey Anthony out of jail. The jail says that Anthony could be released from behind bars as early as 8:30 a.m. tomorrow morning. Anthony will be required to wear an ankle monitor, and according to bounty hunter Leonard Padilla, will be on 24-hour watch.
Is somebody going to be keeping an eye on the house?
Oh, yeah, we'll have security people living there. Yeah, here's the thing. There's been threats against her, so we also have to protect her from that. You know, we can't just, okay, see ya, and somebody blows her away. No, there's been a lot of threats against her, and we don't want her to get harmed.
Anthony is also scheduled to be arraigned on felony child neglect and false statement charges tomorrow morning at the Orange County Courthouse, where she is expected to plead not guilty to the two counts, which could result in nearly 6 years behind bars.
Good evening. I'm Pat LaLama in for Nancy Grace. Breaking news tonight. Police desperately still searching for a three-year-old Florida girl named Kaylee. And just moments ago, $50,000 bond posted so mom Casey Anthony can walk out of jail.
Just a couple of minutes ago, Al Estes, a Miami bail bondsman who has been working with the bounty hunter Leonard Padilla, showed up here at the central booking area of the jail. He is going to file all of the paperwork necessary to post bond to get Casey Anthony out of jail. This is a process that will probably have Casey Anthony not getting out of the Orange County Jail any earlier than about mid to late morning tomorrow. Casey Anthony is facing numerous charges, but the most serious right now is a third-degree felony, and that is child neglect. She will be on an electronic monitor at her home in East Orange County. If she goes any more than 150 feet from that home, authorities will know about it. What do you think the chances are
zero.
That she is going to skip out of town?
Zero. Where's she going to go? The girl's never been out of town. She's never been out of the county. Where's she going to go? I can't find any trace that she's ever been anywhere except right here living with her parents.
So far, everything that Casey has done has indicated that she is not fit to tell the truth. Until that happens, whether she's in jail or at home, nothing's going to change.
Well, here we go. Pat LaLama in for Nancy Grace. And right in my hands, hot off the jailhouse presses, the bond document. This is it. It will be done. And we will go right to Mark Williams, news director, WNDB News Talk 1150. Hey, Mark, give us the latest.
Well, Pat, it's been a very exciting day here in Orange County. Of course, just moments ago, Tampa bail bondsman Tony Estes posting $50,000 bond. That's 10% of the $500,000 bond that Casey Anthony is being held on in the Orange County Jail. She could be out of jail as early as 8:30 tomorrow morning, but the big deal is that's not going to happen right away if everything is fine. What's going to happen is she probably won't be out till midday or even by mid-afternoon. She's got to jump through a couple of hoops, Pat. First off, they must notify Orange County Sheriff's investigators as to what's going on. She must jump through another hoop. It's an internal hold, as they say. They won't say what it is. We have a feeling it's a quick psychological test to see if she's able to go out into be released with that ankle monitor. And of course, the ankle monitor will continue to monitor her when she's in the house. As we documented earlier this week, the Anthonys have installed a private line into that residence. It can't have any sort of a cable phone modem or anything else on that line. It must be a clear line so she can go out there and join her parents once again over in East Orange County, Pat.
Well, you know what? It's a very interesting a matter of events today because Nikki Pierce, who's a reporter for WDBO Radio, I mean, we know there were glitches, and those glitches have apparently been deglitched.
I suppose they have been deglitched. There were a number of problems that were cropping up, some red tape. It was a little bit more difficult to transfer a bond from California to Florida and so on, and checking on the phone line, as Mark Williams mentioned. But it looks like everything is clear, and Mr. Padilla was at the Orange County Jail today, along with Al Estes, posting the bond.
Oh, and we will talk to him in just moments, I guarantee you. Natisha Lance, Nancy Grace producer. Hey, Natisha, she's going home. I can only imagine what that neighborhood is going to be like. It almost seems to me it would be better to put her in an undisclosed location rather than home.
Well, Mr. Padilla has said that there will be 24/7, around the clock, people from his camp who will be watching on Casey to ensure that nobody will harm her, to make sure also that she won't flee as well. But there were previous reports that Cindy Anthony was looking into possibly a safe house for Casey, because there have been threats made against the family, and there also were some threats or indications that Casey might be harmed when she gets out of jail.
Well, let's go right to the man of the hour, Leonard Padilla. How you doing, Leonard? I have to congratulate you. You came to do what you said you were going to do, and you done it, so to speak. What happens now?
Well, tomorrow she goes in for the, it's an evaluation. That's what the hold is.
The psychological evaluation. Could,
right. The doctor could still say, no, I don't want her released.
And on what grounds that he would feel maybe she's a danger to herself, or
a danger to herself is mainly what they've come up with on some occasions. Not a danger to the public or society, but a danger to herself. The DA could add charges.
Lots of things could happen.
There's still a lot of things that can happen, but we don't believe that they will. But if they do, that's out of our control. The bondsman posted. The law enforcement agency, the jail, the investigating agency has to be notified.
All right. Well, you know, lots of people are interested with lots of questions. So let's start taking those questions first from Diane in Florida. Hi, Diane.
Hi, how you doing?
Great. What's your question?
Well, first I want to tell you, you're doing a great job on this investigation.
Thank you.
Is it possible that it was an accident and the reason she borrowed the shovel and stole the gasoline from her parents, that possibly, maybe, God forbid, she may have burned the body to get rid of evidence?
Well, you know, that's the question people ask. Renee Rockwell, let's keep in mind that she has not been charged with anything but a child neglect and false statements. But the question is, where is her daughter? And our caller wants to know, could it have been an accident?
Absolutely. And the thing is she needs to get lawyered up. She needs to decide what the story is. She needs to stop talking because she's painting herself into a corner, Pat. That's what she needs to do.
How
get a lawyer and stop talking.
Well, you know, Leonard, let me ask you. I mean, you're going to try to talk to her. You think that freedom will instigate openness in terms of what happened. You know, how much do you want her to talk, and do you only want her to talk to you?
Well, here's the situation. You know, I probably won't be talking to her tomorrow or the next day or two or three days down the road. I think it's important that she get in there and be with her family. She's got a brother that she's very close to. Let them deal with her the first few days. In spite of what that idiot Bo Diddle up in New York's claims, I have no intentions of talking to her or taking her and a six-pack of beer to a motel. Let her be with her family for a few days.
Hugo Rodriguez, defense attorney, what would you advise her to do at this point? You cannot deny that the fact that she'll be at home where there will be helicopters flying around and reporters around and everybody wants a piece of her. How would you handle this?
My first advice to her would be that any conversation she has with anyone, including Mr. Padilla, her mother, her brother, or anyone else, is not privileged. She's got to be concerned about who she talks to and what she says to anyone if she's going to protect herself and her own rights. That's the first thing I would tell her. I would tell her to get healthy, and we would sit down and talk about our defense strategy and prepare for this upcoming trial for which she's going to be arraigned for tomorrow.
Leslie Austin, psychotherapist. What's it like for a young woman to be in jail? I mean, you know, it's terrible for anybody, but looking at her case, she's a mother. Her daughter's missing. We don't know the circumstances. What's it been like for her? She's been alone. It's not really solitary confinement, but she has been separated from the other prisoners.
Well, it's pretty terrible to be in that circumstance for any reason, but with her daughter missing, with the intense media scrutiny, and with her family talking so much, she has no control over anything, so it's got to be enormously painful and frustrating. I, too, hope that she goes home and stays quiet for a little while to regroup and decide what she's going to say and what she's not going to say, and hopefully she'll tell the truth.